हेलो, आई एम प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनीष गुप्ता. द वीडियो वी आर शोइंग हेयर इज एन पेशेंट वी रिसीव्ड इन एन एमरजेंसी विद एन ट्रिकियोस्टमी ट्यूब ब्रोकन डाउन इनटू पीसेज एंड माई द डिस्टल एंड माइग्रेटेड इनटू द लोअर एयरवे. इट वाज रिमूव्ड वाया ब्रोंकोस्कोप. एज यू कैन सी इन द चेस्ट एक्सरे, द ट्यूब वॉज ऑक्यूपाइंग द पार्ट ऑफ द कैराइना एंड गोइंग इन टू द राइट मेन ब्रोंकस. And patient was long being tracheostomized for 22 years following some laryngeal anomaly. And we are doing a fiber optic bronchoscopy via tracheostomy tube, freshly inserted and cuff inflated for giving ventilatory support. The procedure was done under general anesthesia. Fiber optic bronchoscopy was done just to ensure where exactly the tube is lying and what kind of pathology or we are dealing with. So after ensuring that yes, there is an ragged edges of the tube which we can see, and going inside the lumen, we just ensured that yes, the tube was not blocked, and so we can easily ventilate the patient. Also, preoperatively there was no lung field changes on chest X-ray, suggesting that the tube must be patent one. See the color of the tube, how old it was and being regularly used by the patient because of the poverty. Then the rigid bronchoscopy was done. We preferred first via tracheostomy only. After removing the tracheostomy tube, the ventilator was attached at the proximal end. After gaining entry into the trachea, we could see the cut edge of the tube again via direct rigid endoscope. Then we mounted this endoscope onto the fiber optic carrier forceps, foreign body forceps, which was again introduced. Through the bronchoscope, and after visualizing the foreign body, it was planned to hold the edge of the cut end of the tracheostomy tube. Some amount of fogging is there because patient was on a ventilator support. Otherwise, we can momentarily stop this ventilator so that we can have a good view. One of the tongue of the forceps was introduced within the lumen of the tube so as to catch hold of the edge. The bronchoscope along with the forceps were withdrawn simultaneously, and the cut end of the tube was easily